Ladies and gentlemen, the Philippine National Anthem. Thank you.
graduates 2014, is brought here by the Lord. They came here 3:30 in the morning. So while you were sleeping, they were preparing to be here, to meet all of you here. So please lend your ears and the rest of us. Our speaker is Congressman Roman T. Romulo. He obtained his Bachelor's of Law degree from the College of Law of the University of the Philippines in 1994, and he became a member of the Philippine Bar the following year. He obtained his pre-law degree in economics from the same university, UP, in 1990. He practiced corporate law with an associate in the Gisumbing Torres as a senior associate later of the CCIP Salazar Hernandez and Gatmaitan, where he specializes in corporate law. Mr. Romulo specializes not only in corporate law, but in special projects, banking, and finance transactions. In 2005, Mr. Romulo co-founded his own law firm, where he's currently on leave. It is called the Tolosa Romulo Agabin and Flores Law Offices. Congressman Romulo was elected member of the House of Representatives and is in the Lone District of Pasig City. He is now on his third term and he serves as chairman on the Committee on Higher and Technical Education. That's why I really said I'd like to invite Congressman Romulo to be here. Congressman Romulo is the author of a number of bills and resolutions of national significance. As early as the first regular session of the 15th Congress, four of his bills of national application were approved by the House of Representatives. They're number one, the Data Privacy Act of 2011. It's known as House Bill number 4115. Second one is House Bill number 4308, known as the Healthcare Services Price Disclosure Act. In other words, that you have to disclose the transparency and requirements of the use of credit cards, amending for the purpose of the purpose Republic Act number 8484. And then the third one is the Act strengthening the transparency and disclosure of all the credit card facilities, otherwise known as the Access Devices Regulation Act of 1998. And the last one is House Bill number 4801, entitled as the Act amending certain provisions of Republic Act number 7581, entitled an Act providing protection to consumers by stabilizing the prices of basic necessities and prime commodities, and by prescribing measures against undue price increases during emergencies. In other words, whether it's an emergency storm or what, the prices usually goes up. Congressman Romulo had a provision that should not be done. It must be prescribed and it must be controlled. Other bills and resolutions filed by Mr. Romulo advances transparency and freedom of information, quality and accessible education, government accountability, and strict implementation of laws and support for various sectors such as agriculture, transportation, labor, foreign affairs, and entrepreneurship. Congressman Romulo has a very wonderful pedigree. His grandfather was the great Carlos P. Romulo. If any Filipino do not know who Carlos P. Romulo is, you must not be a Filipino. Because Carlos P. Romulo was the past president of the General Assembly of the United Nations. He was the first Asian to hold such position. His mother, past Secretary of Foreign Affairs, Alberto Romulo. And so we see, and we have a man here who is destined to greatness. He also married a wife, beautiful wife, very popular wife, Shalani Sarinan, the co-host of Wawawi. Bring your wife along.
And so, ladies and gentlemen, graduates 2014, it is with distinct honor and parents that I present to you the guest, honor, and speaker of the hour, Congressman Roman Romulo.
Dr. Don Leo M. Grilba, President, Mountain View College, Pastor Pangulag, Pastor Gulpan, Pastor Asui, Dr. Paglinawan, Mr. Eric Barnuevo, Dr. Catolico, Dr. Caballero, Dr. Jundero, Dr. Aso, Dr. Adel, Pastor Aganyo, all the faculty members of Mountain View College, to the parents, and most especially to our graduates, a pleasant morning to all of you. As stated by your president, first of all, we want to thank him for inviting us to grace this commencement, this 80th commencement exercise of your school. As mentioned by your president, it was actually quite a journey for my wife and I as we actually arrived at 4 a.m. this morning here. We flew in from Tacloban to Metro Manila and then back here. So we, from Davao City going here, we arrived here at 4 a.m. And along the way, I was telling the president, in fact, that we even got a flat tire at 2 in the morning, but we were really meant to attend this commencement exercise. Along the way, my wife and I were very excited actually, not only to see her college, but in fact, for both of us, this is our first time in the province of Bukidnon. And being the first time in Bukidnon, it is a pleasure and honor for both of us to be before you, the graduates of this prestigious college. Of course, to our graduates, this morning when we arrived, I was reading through the blue book, the program provided to us. And it appeared there that it has been quite a hectic and busy schedule for you this past couple of 4 or 3 days. In the program, nakita ko po doon na merong parte rin na pagbibigay po ninyo ng pasalamat or thanking your parents. In fact, I think that is one of the very good program of this school to give thanks to your parents. When you were walking in, upo kami dito sa harap mag-asawa, tumitingin kami, nakita naman po namin na very proud kayo na magtatapos kayo, and you have that right. But hindi nyo po nakita dahil katabi po ninyo. Pero ang totoo po, mas proud pa po yung katabi po ninyo nung pagpasok po nila ninyo. So I hope you will never, and I'm sure you will never forget to always thank your parents. Equally as important is to also never to forget to thank the faculty, your professors, teachers here in this college. They, together with you, gave a lot of effort in order for you to reach this morning's graduation. So I hope before you leave your campus this morning, you do not forget to approach each of your professors to thank them. Alam po ninyo mga graduates, talagang napaka-importante po ng umaga na ito para sa inyo. At I hope and I know that you appreciate what is happening here this morning. I am sure that you have read a lot of the commentaries of our DepEd officials and CHED officials. And you know the statistics. Of 100 students who enter elementary, only about 73 pass at the elementary level, and only about 58 proceed to high school. Of those who graduate from high school, only 23 of that 100 proceed to college. And of that 23 who proceeded to college, about 50% graduate. So makikita po ninyo, very elite po ang mga students po na college graduates dito sa ating bansa. Almost only 10% of those who enter elementary level finish college. So kayo po, bilang kasama dun sa 10% na yan, kayo po ang inaasahan po ng ating bayan na magiging future leaders, whether sa business, sa politics, sa public service, o kung ano man po ang tahakin po ng landas ng inyong buhay. Kayo po ang ine-expect, you are expected to be the future leaders of this country. And you have nothing to fear. We mentioned earlier that you have to thank your parents, your teachers, your professors for helping you graduate. But let us never forget, graduates, that the reason why you are here this morning, why you are being given a diploma, is because of the hard work that you have put into your studies. Wala pong iba na pumasok araw-araw sa klase. Walang iba na kumuha ng mga examination at tests sa araw-araw. There was no one else who made those assignments given by your professors. There was no other person but you yourself who studied on a daily basis. There was no other person given those passing marks by this college but you, because of your hard work. Kaya sana po, huwag po niyong kalimutan na kaya kayo nandito ngayon umaga ay dahil sa sarili po ninyong pagsisikap. It was your hard work that brought you here this morning. So it is also those qualities which will help you in your future career. What does it mean po to be a graduate? Of course, it means that you have learned the academic curricula provided to you by your various colleges. But more than that, it means that you have that emotional stability, you have that talent, you have that perseverance to work hard to meet all the challenges presented to you by your professors in the school. After you graduate, when you move on to your careers, all these qualities po will still be very helpful to you. Magagamit po ninyo lahat itong mga qualities na ito. Alam ko po, bilang isang estudyante rin po, na dati, nung tayo'y dumaan ng college, ay hindi naman po araw-araw ay napakaganda ng ating performance. There were days, I am sure, that you had difficulty also. There were days that you probably had low grades or you did not pass an examination. But despite that, nandito po kayo ngayon umaga. Ganyan rin po sa buhay. Imposible po na araw-araw ay magigising po kayo. You will wake up every day and your day will be perfect. That is an impossibility. And such is life. Pagising niyo po sa araw-araw, may mga araw po na mahihirapan rin po kayo. Meron po kayong kausap na hindi tutupad sa usapan. Meron po kayong mga kausap na hindi magkakaintindihan po sa kagustuhan po ninyo o ng kumpanya po ninyo. But always remember that all these challenges and difficulties that you will go through, you went through all this when you were in college, when you were in this college.
So kayang-kaya niyo po lahat itong mga challenges and problems na ito. Kailangan lang po perseverance and hard work, qualities that you have proven you possess. But in addition to this quality that I mentioned, and I suppose this quality I want to impart and I impart on all graduates. Minsan po, there are times when we Filipinos, when we graduate,
we feel that the graduate from another school or from another country is better than us. But that is not true. Ang curriculum po na pinag-aaralan po ng bawat programa sa iba-ibang kolehiyo, hindi lang po dito sa Pilipinas, pero kahit sa ibang bansa, pare-pareho na po yung curriculum na yan. Kung anong alam nila, what they know, for sure you know too. Kung anong dinaanan po nila, dinaanan nyo rin po. That is why I hope that in addition to the qualities we mentioned earlier, one more quality that you should possess when you leave this graduation is magkaroon po kayo ng tiwala sa sarili. Confidence. You must possess that because that is one quality that will help you face any person or any challenge that will befall you in your professional careers. Earlier po, na-mention po ng inyong presidente na kamag-anak ko po si Carlos P. Romulo. Nabanggit po niya na si Carlos P. Romulo was the first Asian president of the General Assembly of the United Nations. In fact, when I was talking to your president, he was clarifying kung hindi ba Secretary General yun, hindi presidente. Nabanggit ko nga po sa kanya, when Carlos P. Romulo became president of the General Assembly of the United Nations, that was in the infancy of the United Nations. Yun po yung kakapanganak pa lamang ng United Nations. That was the time after World War II wherein we were saved by other countries who helped us conquer our foes. But Carlos P. Romulo, in his writings, always said that when he went to the United Nations, even if other countries felt that the Philippines was not a first world country, was not a superpower, he believed that in the United Nations, wherein ideas of the minds will be what is important, it does not matter what country you belong to or where you come from. What is important is that you assert yourself and you be confident that you know what you are saying. That is why when he first entered the United Nations, he insisted that he be given the opportunity, the Philippines being a member of the United, one of the pioneer members of the United Nations, to be able to address the General Assembly and to convince them that he could lead the United Nations. I mention that because as graduates now, paglabas po ninyo ng activity natin ngayon umaga, hindi po katulad ng mga nakaraang araw, nakaraang linggo, nakaraang buwan, or for the past years, if you had any problem, pwede po kayong pumunta sa mga professors po ninyo, sa mga kaklase po ninyo, sa mga magulang po ninyo para humingi ng payo. After today, you will be, chances are, left on your own because you have earned a degree. It is assumed that you will know how to meet the challenges. So I hope, together with the qualities earlier mentioned about perseverance and hard work, huwag po ninyong kalimutan na magtiwala po sa sarili ninyo. You must have, I hope, the belief in yourself that you can face any challenges. And I am sure that is what was imparted to you by this college. But before I let you go, graduates, As I was reading also through this blue book, I saw part of the message of your president about continuing your thirst for knowledge, continuing your education. Even as graduates, I hope, just as your president, that you continue your thirst for knowledge and that you continue in your life wanting to learn more, wanting to adapt to changes, wanting to adjust to the various situations. I hope that you as graduates, as our future leaders of this country, will take it upon yourselves to be the true Filipino that you are supposed to be. Again, congratulations, mabuhay po kayo, mabuhay po ang inyong paaralan.